Welcome, everyone. I'll be presenting this great material that Rick Ellis, our product owner for the BricsCAD Civil Survey platform, has put together for us. GIS data have become increasingly valuable assets to infrastructure projects. In V24, we're bringing the ability to access, create, edit, and export GIS data in a consistent and practical way to CAD users with a familiar environment. No need to purchase and learn specific GIS software. You can leverage the CAD tools you already know and love in BricsCAD to work with GIS data. Whether you are creating and managing GIS data and need to round-trip it from a GIS system, or if you're simply using the GIS data as a background, then BricsCAD has practical tools with a consistent workflow to handle it. In this breakout session, we will show you how BricsCAD V24 can convert drawings with object data from AutoCAD Map and Civil 3D into BricsCAD GIS data, view, search, filter, and edit GIS data in an easy-to-use table, import GIS data, create new GIS data tables and features, delete GIS data, and export it. You'll see how all GIS data is filtered, viewed, created, and edited in the same way, regardless of the source or how it was created. Let's get started. We'll start with a drawing that contains a sewer network with sewer lines as polylines and line segments, and the sewer structures displayed as blocks. Both these lines and blocks have object data attached to them, coming from either AutoCAD Map 3D or Civil 3D. To convert these into the GIS data format that we have in BricsCAD, we go to the Civil Explorer, and we can see here that this drawing doesn't have any GIS layers yet. So we'll pick Convert from Object Data, and BricsCAD searches through the entire drawing, finds any objects that contain object data or have object data attached to them, converts that object data to a BricsCAD GIS feature, and then deletes the object data left behind so that there's no redundant information within our drawing. You can then see we have a sewer pipe data layer and sewer structures. The display of both of these can be controlled just by toggling the visibility buttons on and off in the Civil Explorer. If we double-click on one of these layers, we can see that all of the GIS data that's attached to these features is visible to us. We can scroll through the table, and if we want to find a particular pipe, so in this case, we're looking for a pipe itself, I can right-click on that feature and pick Select to highlight it within the drawing. I can also right-click it and either pick Zoom to or Pan to. So let's close out of this table, zoom back out, and try the other direction. I'll bring up the table again, and this time I want to find a particular object in the drawing somewhere in the table. We just pick the Select button, click on a particular pipe that we're interested in, and this could be one or more features. And you can see it's highlighted in our table. In this case, this was an 8-inch PVC pipe. We can also filter through this data. So go to the filter, and in this case, perhaps filter by size. We'll find all of the pipes that are greater than or equal to 10 inches. Apply that filter, and we can see that we have 81 out of the 348 objects selected. If I want to compound that filter, so add something else, I can go back and add the material to it as well. Let's say I want the material to be any pipes that are PVC. Now with that compound filter, we're down to 27 different objects. If I select all of those, and then right-click and pick Select, when I close out of the dialog box, what we see is the types that are 10 inches or larger with PVC material are all highlighted for us. So it's a really easy way for us to sort through large amounts of data and find exactly the pieces we're looking for. Of course, any of this information could be edited in the table. Double-click on the table, just go back and select that feature. It says here that it's an 8-inch pipe, but in this case, it was supposed to be a 12-inch pipe. We can type that in and update it here. And of course, this data could then be exported back out to a shapefile to be integrated back into your GIS system. Similarly, we can import GIS data just by going to the Import GIS Layers. I'll browse and I'll find the shapefile that I want to import here. So in this case, we have street center lines. When we import that file, the program shows me that the layer type or the GIS layer type is lines. The layer is going to be drawn on is called streets. Now, of course, I could change that to something else, or if I wanted to pick it from my template, I could do that. And it's going to create a GIS layer called streets. I'll just pick import and it brings those streets overlaying the other data that we have, our sewer network. And I can work with that data just like I worked with any of the other GIS data that we imported from the object data. So it's exactly the same interface, very easy for us to use. I can close the table, I'll turn off the streets, and let's say that now we wanted to add a pipe to the pipe network. I'll zoom into the location and I'll just draw a polyline. I'll start it at the end of this other pipe. And now we'll use one of the new transparent commands that comes in BricsCAD V24. If I type in apostrophe BD for bearing and distance, you could also pick it off the ribbon on the panel. It will prompt me for a quadrant bearing and distance. So I know that in this case, the pipe is supposed to go northwest. That will be this quadrant here. You can see a red line that gives you a visual guide as to where you're going with the line. So I can type in the bearing for that. I'm just going to say it's 12 degrees, 34 minutes and 56 seconds. And it locks me in on that bearing. You can see I can't go anywhere else. And we'll just say that this pipe is 100 feet long. Now, currently, this is just a polyline. It doesn't know it's a GIS feature and it doesn't have any data associated with it. But if I went back to the sewer pipe data layer and picked add GIS feature, I can pick that line, hit enter, and we'll see in the table it has added the new feature. Now we can add some data to it. So we could say that this is a pipe of 8 inches. The project number is 2-123, and the pipe will be PVC. So that new object has been added to this GIS layer. You can see that it disappears when we turn off the visibility, just like any of the other features. So we have one consistent interface, whether we're creating data from scratch, importing it from a shapefile, or whether you're converting it from object data. In addition, you may want to create your data completely from scratch. So that means creating the table and layer definition as well. So for example, perhaps we wanted to add a layer that represents water mains. In this case, we can go to Create GIS Layer here in the Civil Explorer on the GIS tab, and we'll give the layer a name. We'll just call it water. The geometry type is either going to be points, lines, or polygons. So this will be lines. And then we can start adding as many fields as we want. We'll add a field. We'll start off with one called size. And the type of data that will be in this field called size will be an integer. Now we'll add one more for material. This particular material field is going to be a string. It's going to be a word. And you can carry on adding new fields, and that will create the new feature table. Click here and we'll see that's it. But we could add additional GIS features. So let's just head out, draw some, and we'll draw these as lines. So we'll put a polyline along parallel to this other segment. Go back to the table. We'll just add features, pick that polyline, and then fill out our size. This is a 6-inch pipe, and the material for this one is PVC. So we've created the new feature, and we have the ability to create a data from scratch or import GIS data and then export it out to a shapefile so that you can use it in any other GIS system. To do that, let's go to the sewer data and just select all the features, right-click and select them. Then all we do is go up to the import-export panel, GIS, and now we've created a shapefile, round-tripped through Bricsys. We hope you enjoyed this quick tour of the new GIS features in BricsCAD V24. Whether you're creating and managing GIS data and need to round-trip it back to a GIS system, or if you're simply using GIS data as background information for your project, BricsCAD now has practical tools with a consistent workflow to handle it. You can edit geometry with familiar CAD commands, and you can edit the data in an intuitive table. GIS data is now easily accessible in your familiar CAD environment. Thanks to Rick for this great session, and thank you all for joining us. Now, don't forget to join our other breakout sessions for more information on how we've improved our workflows for civil and survey users.